Good morning, everybody. Welcome behind the scenes here at Jamie Ridler Studios. I'm Jamie, and it is Friday. How did it get to be Friday? Now, not that I'm not happy it's Friday. I'm delighted it's Friday. I love Fridays. One, because of Journal Club. Hey, Journal Clubbers. I'm so excited to hang out with you today, and I've been dreaming up what we're going to do. But man, this week seemed to go really quickly. And this week in the studio, I've been really focused on getting the first 100 print copies of the spring yearbook out. And you can see I'm still in the midst of it and should have it out and in the mail for those of you who are waiting for yours on Monday. And it has been launching something new. Is always full of learning. Shannon and I keep saying to one another, learning, learning, learning. With maybe a little, we do it in text or type, so it doesn't have that little tone to it that I just added. But just that feeling of whenever you do something new, there will be learning. And we talked about this last week, that means there will be discomfort. But there'll also maybe be excitement. There'll also maybe be stretch. And as you learn, gather. You know, one of the things that we have on the daily page in the yearbook is a section called Insight. And what that's meant to do is to give you a place every day to gather that learning, to lock it in, to put in words in a place where you can see and have a reminder, this is what I now know. This is what I now know. Because so often we just sort of scrape through something, especially when it's hard, and then we stumble on to the next thing and life gives us our next challenge and we're in it already and we haven't even had time to integrate what we had learned before. And think about that when you're in school. I think about it for math, when it moved a little to, or French, things that build on what you learned before. You know, and when it moves just a little too fast for you, you feel like you're always getting behind, like you're doggy paddling, apparently, like you're always getting behind and you can't get that toehold. And the reason is it's not just learning, it's letting it steep in you. It's letting it be integrated so that it becomes a part of your knowing. And that happens, one, by being aware of it, by reminding yourself of it, by practicing it over and over and over again till it becomes a part of you. And it's true, the world doesn't stop while you do that. So this is a way for me, I created in the yearbook, and I hope it works for you too, to have a place every day to tune in. What was my learning today? What was my learning today? And sometimes that learning will be really practical, like you need to fill out customs forms when you send something across the border to the US. Like, that's an important thing to know. And then sometimes that learning will be more personal, more internal, where I might say, that's right. I'm always tired 3 days after a launch, and I need to work in some rest. I have a very gravelly voice today, and that's probably telling me that I've been pushing, you know, working a little too hard, a little too long. But it's a wonderful feeling. I love being in this stretch of excitement, this getting things ready, this wrapping up packages. It feels like Christmas. And I'm so excited to send these out to everyone. And remember, even if you weren't able to get a print copy of the spring yearbook, you can still get the PDF and print it yourself. And you will be all set to go on March 20th, which is the first day of spring. I also want to point out that next week, speaking of spring, is the full worm moon. Oh, even though it's got a kind of wiggly name, this is one of my very favorite moons of the year. Perhaps because my favorite season is spring. But this is the time when you start waking up again. The time when you start to move. The time when those little seeds of desire start to wiggle again. And the moon invites you to pay attention so that you can make some space, aerate the earth. And let those thoughts and ideas wiggle their way to life. Wiggling is powerful. Try it today, you know. Put on some music and do a little wiggle Wiggle your shoulders. Do it with me now. You know, let's wiggle our heads, our shoulders, wiggle our arms, our rib cage. Can you do that? Our hips. Wiggle, wiggle. Our legs, our feet. I did one at a time. Right leg, wiggle. Right foot. Left leg, left foot. Hands, wiggle your hands. Wiggling, not just for children anymore. Speaking of not just for children, either is making art and having it up on display. And so it's one of the reasons why I created the Bulletin Board Art Invitational. I love having art come in from you. I love inspiring you and encouraging you to make some art. And today I'm going to encourage you also to display some of your art, not just on my bulletin board, which of course I'm happy to do. And I do have some treasures to share, but also your own. You know, if you are a creative and if you have been making things, when was the last time you put something up? Put something up on your fridge, put something up on your wall, put something up on your bulletin board. Frame something. A couple of years ago, I took a class with Carla Sondheim and Lynn Whipple called The Year of Spark. And I'm pretty sure it was in that class that we had an exercise to frame a piece of work that we had done. And putting a frame on your work is absolutely magical. I'll show you mine. It is literally a simple little drawing that I did on computer paper with a marker. Nothing fancy, not a fancy marker, just a marker. Right? And suddenly my bear feels kind of special. Like I could, you know, it's so funny. I'm like speaking of children, like I could totally see him on a nursery wall or on my studio because that's apparently the way I roll. I just love animals. So, but I also love stars. And that is what we're going to look at today. So let us go to our bulletin board art invitational. Remember, it's not too late for you to send me art. The address to where to send it will be at the end of the video. Our theme this season is stars. I'm not sure 100% when I'll be wrapping up the BTS for this season. Probably the end of the first week in April. That's likely to be the case. Okay, let's see what we have here. It's from BC here in Canada. Oh my goodness, wait till you see this. It is made by Susan. It is called Stars. Okay, here it is. Spectacular. Look at this. Wow. Can you see that this little window that she has is full of stars and has a star here at the bottom. It has a star here on the top. And it's wonderful what Susan's done is attach a little tag that says BTS, Susan Stars, February 2018. Susan, this is gorgeous. Thank you so much. I cannot wait. Oh my gosh, can't you tell how beautiful it already looks in the studio? I love that color story. Susan, thank you so much for making a star and for sending it in. What a treat. Okay, now we have one from another one all the way from BC. That's the other side of the country. Here in Canada. So I guess BC, is it fair to say BC to Toronto? Am I going to get in trouble for this? BC to Toronto is Portland to New York. Fair? I'm just trying to give people a sense of distance who maybe don't know Canada so very, very well. So this has come with a letter, so I'm going to have to rock the reading glasses. So this is from Sandeep. Hey, Sandeep. Oh my goodness, you have written me a beautiful letter that just went straight to my heart. I am so excited that we've connected. I am so excited that the creative spark in you is coming out and shining. And I'm so excited that you have shared it with us. So this is her beautiful drawing. And it says, all of us together are starlight. Uniquely shining so bright with all our might. Oh, how marvelous is this sight. It certainly is marvelous. Thank you for shining your light, and in doing this, also encouraging others to shine theirs too. Mwah. Thank you, Sandeep. Now we have something from Kathy, who is in Pickering, Ontario. Oh, that's all Canadians today. That doesn't usually happen. Hello, my Canadian friends. Very exciting. Let's see what Kathy has to share. Wow. Oh my goodness. Okay, look at this. So Kathy used some large cardstock to wrap her stars in, she said we can use them for, I mean, I love this, Kathy, so much. It's some jelly printing that she's done that I totally thought this was the art. I am crazy for it. So thank you for sending that too. But in fact, these beauties are meant to protect the stars. Look. Oh my gosh. I am amazed what you guys are doing with stars. And she's written her name on them. So remember, everybody, I'm asking you to really claim your space as an artist when you make something for the bulletin board invitational, and to like write your name on it, to sign your work. So Kathy has put her signature, said that these are February 18th, and that they are made from jelly prints and molding paste and glitter. Oh, stars are making me so happy. Thank you so much for those, Kathy. I just love them. And we have one more from Brittany. Hey, Brittany, I hope you're doing well. It's always lovely to see you in my mailbox. And another Canadian. So we have four Canadian stars today. So Brittany has shared that she has just started learning felting. She is absolutely loving it. And she is using that to create a kindness project with more of these beautiful, beautiful stars. Look, one, two, three. And she said she held me and my sisters in her heart when she was making these. So Susie and Shannon, you each get a star too. Thank you so much, Brittany. These are beautiful, and I'm so excited to be able to share them with my sisters. Wow. The creativity, the love, the joy, the reminders that we are capable of creating and sharing. I know sometimes sharing is hard. I know a lot of times sharing is hard. And we never know. We can't control what's going to happen when we share. We don't know how people will react. We don't know whether they will absolutely love what we share, or they will be grateful for it, or they will resent it. And I remember how healing it was for me. Years ago, I was in a mastermind group. Some of you will remember me going to Art Picnic. And at Christmas, when I just first learned how to crochet, I crocheted everybody a beret and brought them into Art Picnic. And everybody was so loving, so delighted, immediately put it on their heads that it just filled my heart. That experience, see, I get even a little sensitive about it now, but just that experience of making something with love and having it received in the same way is such a glorious gift. But it does require risking. I've certainly had the opposite too, where I've shared something and the person who received it was not interested, didn't like it. It seemed like somehow I got it wrong. I wasn't good enough. It wasn't good enough. Whatever. It wasn't the right fit. That just whatever reason, that it's sort of like a seed that got planted and just hit rock instead of soil. And that's going to happen sometimes. But when you remember, like, this would be the kind of thing I would write in my insight, and maybe I'll write it again today. But when you remember that sometimes you drop a seed and it lands on fertile soil, and that is a blessing, then it makes you a little braver. It makes you a little bolder. It soothes your poor, tender heart and allows you to just go, oh, yeah, that was hard rock. Of course it didn't grow there. I'm going to move over here and try again, and maybe here I'll find soil. I hope you find soil here. Thank you for sending your stars. Thanks for thinking about sending a star. I hope today just create a star or consider it for this weekend. I could give you a little bit of creative homework this weekend in your studio. And yes, your life is your studio. Make a star. Just make it first and then you can decide whether you want to send it to me. If you do, I promise I'll love it. I hope you have a wonderful weekend in your studio. I hope to have a wonderful one in mine. I am still immersed in the experience of this first round of the yearbook, pulling together everything to send it out and hoping that it will land in the fertile soil of 100 creative lives. Have a good weekend. I'll see you Tuesday.